Purvobhyasa, the first among two forms which iteration yields, is termed abhyasa. And then ube abhyastam, jo iti vartaman ube graham samudaya sangya pratipatyarthah. See what he is saying? Hey, you already have two. Why do you have to use ube? He is using ube just to let you understand that the term abhyasta is assigned not to any one, just one of them, but together as one form. So ube abhyastam, the two forms which iteration yields are both termed abhyasa. And then you have jakshit syadaya sat. This is a group of the roots which are called jaksha, etc. There the particular operation takes place. Suffices to say that these two terms, abhyasa and abhyasta, together operations relative to the terms abhyasa and abhyasta, they are technically referred to in the literature by the term abhyasakarya. So, at the beginning of the sixth adhyaya, the first operation you undertake is the dvitva karya, and this is called the sashtamika dvitva, because there is another dvitva in the eighth adhyaya. So, in order to separate this doubling from that doubling, you use the term sashtamika and the ashtamika. So anyway, except for abhyas karya, there isn't much. So let's just scan here. Tujadinam dirgho abhyasasya. Liti dhatur anabhyasasya. See abhyasasya, anabhyasasya. This is a reference to abhyasa for carrying out certain operation. Saniyango, that does the doubling. Shlu, shlau, juhotyadi, bhyashluhu. That's the doubling of the juhotyadi roots. Changi, parato abhyasasya dhatur avayavasya prathamasya ekacho dvitiyasya va yatha yogam dve bhavata. This is again doubling. Das one, sa one, mid one. Bandhuni bahu brihau. Liti abhyasa se uvesam. See again, here abhyasa. Swapeshchami, swapeshchami, vyayamyami, navarsah chayaki. There is a great author, there was a great author in the Hindi literature, Hajari Prasad Dwivedi. You must have heard of him. And so I had been visiting since my childhood Hajari Prasad Dwivedi. So one day, he asked me, hey, did Pāṇini drink tea? I said, no, how would he drink tea? Unless you interpret kashaya painu gandharaha, so that tea drinker. So he said, no, he says chayaki. See this chayaki? And then you have pyayapi. But then the other day he would ask me, hey, did Pāṇini was post-Christ or pre-Christ? I said, of course pre-Christ. So I said, no, how come he says abhyasa charcha? So there were charges at the time of Pāṇini. Shritam pake pyayapi. See, this is pyayapi, chayaki, pyayapi. Samprasaranam. This is samprasarana. So this is the end of the abhyas karya. See? Prak samprasaran sanshabdanat. So purvam. This is the extent of the abhyas karya. Period. And then bhaulam chandasi. So here, after that, he goes to samprasarana. What's happening here? He is taking individual forms or forms of words, and then he is applying operations to the sound, the samprasarana. Beginning with samprasarana. Na samprasarana samprasaranam, his warning. You cannot apply a samprasarana when another samprasarana has already taken place. सेट्रालिटी वयो यः वश्चास्यान्य सरस्यां लपि च ज्यश्च व्यश्च विभाषा परे आदे च उपदेशे अस्ति. दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रूल. एजन्तो यो धातुरुपदेशे तस्याकारादेशो भवति शेति तु प्रत्यय न भवति. व्हाट इज उपदेश? We talked about it. Upadesh Adyocharanam Bhattuji Dikshit say. What is Adyocharana? Adyocharana is in the context of a dhatu which has been freshly taken from the dhatupatha and put there in the Ashtadhyayi. That's what the Adyocharana is, the first place where it has been mentioned. I call it initial citation. So anyway, adesha udeshe asiti navayo liti chakhingiram nau minati minuti dingam lepicha vibhakhidesh chandasi viveter hetu bhaye etc. So you have samprasarana after doubling and abhyas karya. Achi Shirsha, this is a Vartika. Vyayam Akshunna Gatrasya, Padbhyam Udvartitasya cha, Vyadhyo Nopasarpanti, Vainati Evam Yoraga. You want to get the translation of this one? Interesting. He who has become strong-limbed by exercise and also who has received foot massage, diseases do not approach him as snakes do not approach Garuda. See what it is? Shastriji, massages. That guy did wonders with my back. I really had a lot of benefit. Tvatvadeshahasa. Remember, we mentioned that there are dhatus. For example, shaha, where you have retroflex citation. Whenever you find a verb root generally mentioned with the retroflex s, sha, like shaha marshane, you must understand that that sha is going to be replaced with sa. And the rule that does it is this, dhatvadeh shaha, sa. Dhaturadesh shakarasya sthane shakaradesho bhavati. That's how far I go on this one. No, naha, this is the same thing. Dhaturadesh ityanivarte dhaturadesh na karasya nakaradesho bhavati. Give me a root which begins with na. Ni. Ni. Nayati. So, all those which begin with, which are cited with na at the adi, those roots get their na replaced with na, no naha. That's why some people, right at the beginning in the prakriya, they replace the na with na. They replace the sha with sa. That should not be done. Unless you reach here. Because there might be some conflict in some operation somewhere. Because the Acharya has done that. There was a note in here, in this copy. Oh, this is one of the most important rules in the 6-1. The earlier important rule in 6-1 was Haladi Sheshaha. That's one rule that you must remember in connection with doubling or abhyaskarya. The other rule you get here is halanga bhyodirgha sutisya prikta hal. Lopa comes in place of a suti and C termed aprikta. Oh God, aprikta. Which, what is aprikta? Aprikta ekal pratyaya, a pratyaya, an affix formed with a single al. What is al? Al is a sound. Varna. Okay? So, aprikta ekala pratyaya, that pratyaya is defined as aprikta. What happens to an aprikta? Goes through deletion. This is also a good rule. 6169, Eng Hraswat Sambuddhe. What is the Sambuddhi? Sambodhana. The nominative singular. Shesha. See, this is what you do. When you read the Asradhyayi and go find out Sambuddhi. What is Sambuddhi? Recall. If you cannot recall, go take a look at it. Next time you don't do that. Okay? And then you get Sangitayam, the most beautiful section with which you are familiar. What is Sangita? Parasya.
Parasunnikarsha Sangita.
Okay, what does that mean?
The proximity.
Varna nam atishaya sannidhi. What is sannidhi? Sannidhi is nikatata, sannidhi, approximation, proximity. Extreme proximity between the varna. What is extreme proximity? One half of a mora. That's the duration. That is what one half of a mora. Adhikaroyam anudattam padavekavarjam iti yavat. So this is the extent of Sanghitayam. Pragetasmat sutradita ita uttaram vakshyamaha Sanghitayam ityon tadveditavyam vakshati iko yada achi dadhyatra madhvatra Sanghitayam itikim dadhyatra madhvatra. Here there is no extreme, there is no proximity.
Is it intentional there?
All he does is he gives you an example, then he gives you counter examples. Okay, let me let me just go straight forward. Give it to you. Why does it say Sanghitayam? This is what it means. Sanghitayam iti kim. Why does he say Sanghitayam? What is the purpose of his saying Sanghitayam? The purpose is so that this sandhi could not apply to Dadhyatra and Madhuatra where there is no extreme proximity. Right? Okay. So that's what it is. This is just by way of citing counter example. I'm not saying that there will not be confusion. I was confused. I wrestled with all these things and then I decided this is the way I was going to go. So that's why you will say, for example, Vakshati, he will state 6167 Iko Yana Achi Dadhyatra Esa. Why do we state the condition of Sanghitayam? When close proximity of sounds, consider the dhyatra, madhuatra. That's what consider is, giving you the example where this does not apply. Che cha amangusha dirgha che tukiti vartate. See here, there is tuk. So that tuk, the augments are introduced in the Adhyaya 6. The first thing was doubling. The second thing was samprasarana. The third thing, you have the augments. Now you have the samhitayam, the sandhi. Okay? So this is what you have to go outline all the miscellaneous operations which have been there. Irrespective of the assignment of the term anga, this is what you have to remember. Because 641 will begin a major block of rules which will be carrying out operations relative to a unit assigned the term anga. So dvitva karya, abhyas karya is one karya. Then there are miscellaneous karyas. And then you get the anga karya. Anga karya you will get with 641. Here you get the samhita. Echovayavayava, you guys know this. There are two types of sandhis with the vowels especially. There is a single replacement, right? And then there is a pararup, purvarup. Single replacement in place of two, single replacement similar to what follows in a sequence. So you have a, you get a replacement similar to a. This is just illustration. Don't take it just technically. So, and then you have chaya yayo shakyarthe. This is all I want to say about sammeta. Oh, there is also one consideration of samanya vishesha and shesha in here. So that is why there are rules to which there are related exceptions in the sandhi. So iko yanaji akara and then akasavarna dirgha, etc. So there is a visheshan vishesha bhava, there is a samanya, the utsarga and apavada bhava among the sandhi rules. Sattva tukor asiddha, sattva tukicha kartavya ekadesho asiddho bhavati. Remember I said there are single replacement for two, and those are two kinds of single replacements. One where a single replacement is selected similar to what follows in the sequence. Another one, a single replacement is selected similar to what precedes in a sequence. Okay? And then, so, also, sattva tukor asiddhaha, this is the only instance in the Ashtadhyayi where the word asiddha is used outside the context of asiddhavat and asiddham. So, these are the only three instances where the word asiddha is used. What is the force? What is 1156? That is vati ghati tattvam. That is the 1156 is sthanivadadesha nal vidhau. Okay, sattva tikora siddhaha samprasarana samprasaranangitsu pratishedho vaktabhya. This is a vartikal, let's not get into that. Adguraha. So, look at the derivation which I have given you. Tavedam, tava idam, khatva indraha, khatva indraha, malindra, mala indra, etc. Where the a and e, they are replaced with a. But, also take a look at Vridhirechi, the following rule. Remember, do you recall the two paribhasas, paribhasa 2 and 3 in the paribhasa Dushekhar, yatho desham sangya paribhasam and karikalam sangya paribhasam? This is what is meant by the expression by the commentators in connection with those interpretive conventions, paribhashas, where they say the yatho desha samskara of, for example, vriddhi of 111 and guna of 112 and the related samskara of eko guna vriddhi, when he has to kanchatah say that let there be vriddhi, let there be guna. So in all those instances, the samskara of the yathodesh must be carried two rules like 6180, vridhirechi and adguna. To facilitate the application of rule 6188 and 6187, the yathodesh samskaras of vridhiradaicha, adenguna and ego guna buddhi must be carried over to rules 6187 and 6188 so that those applications can be carried out.
One question about that last line. Mrukarasya sthane yontasya laparatva vishyate. Is it a vartika or is it something?
Must be. This is not a vartika. And I'm glad you asked the question. When you get a statement such as this with ishyate, this is called ishti. So you have vrittis, you have vartikas. Among the vartikas, you have two types, the upasankhyana vartikas and the vartikas. Upasankhyana vartikas are particular vartika, they deal with the special situations, particular situations, as against the generalized statements, which are the vartikas. Okay? Then you have ishtis, ishyate. So Katyayana has not issued its vartika on that one, but generally it is the bhashya that interjects in and says, this is also desired.
Where do we get that Ruru Varana Yoha Vitha Savarniyam Vachyam?
Oh, that's the Vartika.
Vartika.
Yeah. See, all statements made with Vachyam, Vaktabhyam, Na Vaktabhyam, etc., etc., these are Vartikas.
In which case, do we want to have Ralayor Abhedaha?
I don't care about that. No, I'm talking about the vartikas. When you have vaktabhyam, then you vaktabhyam, and that is a vartika. Bhattoji Dikshit does all kinds of things. I'm sorry, I don't want to go there.
That was a very tricky thing.
Yeah. You know what hair splitting is? Dikshit does that hair splitting a lot, which you can conveniently disregard with all due respect to him. Okay. Ete dhatushu. See, there are many, many vartikas in the Samhitayam section because of the usage. Abhyaktanukarana syata itau abhyaktam aparisputa varnam tadanukaranam parisputa varnam eva. Akasavarne dirgha, akasavarne achi parata pur purayo sthane dirgha ekadesha bhavati dandagram tadindra madhudgeho drishya akaitikim agnaye, etc. Let's not get into that. We start reading that maybe in the seventh grade. Akasavarne dirgha.
The reason why Ruti Savarne dirghe is Ruti Savarne dirghe.
What is that? Oh, let's not get there. Ami purva samprasaranacha. See, this is what it shows. You know, once I get sick and tired of something and I'm not getting anywhere, just I leave that. This is the place. Ura anara para. Questions, questions, questions. But I don't want you to know what was bothering me.